Hello everyone and welcome to Brilliant Bob, which is a 3D platformer on Steam. You may notice Bob looks a little bit different than he did in the intro, and that's because I bought an extra skin with the coins you could collect. The stage select screen is not actually a stage select screen as you're seeing here, it is a platforming section by itself. Now the first thing about Bob's jumping mechanics. The double jump takes you much further than the single jump, to the point that the single jump is almost entirely useless. I think that was intentional, though. We do have to stand inside the goal for a certain period of time before the stage ends. Here's the game's combat. This never really comes up again. You never actually need to fight enemies. So this is kind of useless. But we can also grab crates and move those. Once I stop playing around with the dead goo body. But it takes them a while to move the crates. You can also jump on the slimes, which is the preferred course of action. You shouldn't kill the slimes, you should use them to jump higher. Using the crates to jump higher is actually more difficult, because they have physics, and you can easily knock them over. But I wanted to show you that it is possible to kill the enemies, even if you should never do that. And you might think, well, that looks fun over there, but behind us, we can get down to this area. And at first you might think, well, they forgot to program a failure state. They forgot to make Bob die. What good game development. But you would actually be wrong, because there are collectibles, for whatever reason, hidden here. They're scrolls. They don't do anything, and nobody else seems to know they exist except for me, because I personally asked the developer why it didn't kill me when I fell off platforms, and in some stages there are hidden scrolls. I don't know how you're supposed to know that, unless you talk to the developer like I did. They said it was to encourage people to explore, but this game is the essence of linearity, so I'm not sure why you would think to explore. Something of note, when a platform moves, it scoots Bob, so you can slide off the platform if you're not standing in the exact center. So be wary of that if you ever play this. Something else of note is that all the art assets, aside from the character models, are not from this studio. They appear to be pre-bought assets from the Unity store. Now, I don't know exactly which asset pack, but more than one Unity game has used these environmental assets. Something that is actually kind of neat about this level is that you need to get to the goal before the slimes do, or else you can't actually use it, since the slimes will be blocking it. But then we just kill them by leading them off the edge. Like that. Something nicer about this game is that the coins are a reference to one of their previous games, Why So Evil. The coins are miniature versions of the cube used in that game. And yes, now we have vanishing platforms. We're still pretty much in tutorial land right now. The game gets rather insanely hard later. And I mean, spend hours trying to get 3 levels further harder. I got through the first 20 stages in about an hour, and it took me another hour to get 3 stages past that. So there is an enormous difficulty wall. We're not going to see it in this video, because I wouldn't be able to get past it. The music ranges from surprisingly appropriate to, I don't know what this is right now. So as you just noticed, the vanishing platforms vanish when we touch them, not when we land on top of them, but when we touch them. So if we accidentally hit one with our head, it goes away. We want to avoid doing that. At first I thought the art style looked actually really nice, and I was going to compliment that, but saw a few other games on Steam Greenlight using the same art style and eventually found out it was indeed an asset pack, so that's not good. Now, to be fair, this game still has some relatively decent effort put into it, but it's worth noting that the developer of this game, Zonitron Productions, has the intention of making a game and releasing it every month. And they've been pretty successful with that. They've released 8 games this year so far, with a 9th already greenlit, I believe. Aside from this, they've created the action puzzle game Why So Evil, the puzzle game Goo Cubelets, and a stealth trilogy featuring a recurring character named Randy. I think the general consensus is that the Stealth Trilogy are their worst titles. I like this level a little bit too, because you have to figure out how to get up to the higher platforms. Since the goal is up in the air, you can't just run through it like it would first appear you can. The music switches every time you die. I believe originally the music was set to, switch when you pass certain levels, but in a recent update they made it so that the music just switches whenever you die. It also does that in their stealth games, which is very weird because some of the music is obnoxiously cheery, which doesn't make a whole lot of sense with the atmosphere they're going for. Or maybe it does and I'm just misunderstanding the atmosphere entirely. Here's a level where we want to actually destroy crates instead of use them so we can actually see forward. We can of course jump on them, but I think the game wanted you to destroy them. We can only move the camera left and right, not in full 360 degree like you would expect. I do still recommend playing this with a gamepad. Trying to play this with a keyboard is maddening. The rule of thumb for these tube platforms is that you want to keep jumping. Trying to balance on them like you think you should does not go very well. Bob is much too slippery for that. But his jumps have far more traction than his running does. Also, sometimes we can glitch the platforms, as you saw there. I wouldn't rely on that, though. It is repeatable, but it is not, reliable. I do like the soft sound when Bob lands on something. That soft thud. I'm really running out of things to talk about, you could tell. But that's a nice sound effect. And I think this is the level we're gonna stop at. You've seen maybe the first 10 levels of Brilliant Bob. About at level 20, they introduce wall jumping, and then it becomes something of a 3D Super Meat Boy. And I'm not going to suffer through that, even for the purposes of this video. So, no. One more cute little thing, you can move around on the title screen. I thought that was actually kind of neat. But that's it for Brilliant Bob. It's not super great. But it's a thing.